Would you like to know if you should pursue a CompTIA A+, Net+, and Linux+? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers. And I've spent 2.5 decades as an IT architect, like a network architect, enterprise architect, business architect, what have you. And I've also spent more than 2 decades helping people get their first tech job, get promoted in tech. And a lot of people are confused when starting their career. Should they do the CompTIA certifications or should they train for their career? So there's really 2 approaches to training, and each has their strengths and weaknesses. And we'll discuss both here. One way is to try to get fundamentals in a lot of different things. This is like the approach in college, where you want to study computers, but you're learning a little bit of English literature, a little bit of history, a little bit of social type studies and those type of things. And you get a lot of stuff, but a little bit in your career. The alternative approach is you get very focused training on just your career. And that's what I did when I started mine. I wanted to work in networking, so I did a CCNA, a CCNP, and a CCIE very quickly. And poof, I had very senior architecture roles as a network architect. So what should you do in the beginning of your career? Do you focus your training or do you take this generic approach to try to learn a lot of fundamentals? Well, it depends. If you know your goal career, I suggest you focus on it because you'll get a lot further, a lot faster by focusing on your career. But what if you don't know your career and you're not sure you want to be, but you just know it wants to be in tech? Well, now that's when that general preparedness, that general fundamentals training makes good sense. So the question will be, will those CompTIA A+, Net+, and Linux+ serve you well in the beginning of your career? Or is there something else that you should do that will help you a lot more? Honestly, I don't ever recommend getting a CompTIA A+, Net+, and Linux+. And here's the reason. They teach good skills, but they're generally too junior for a hiring manager to want to hire you. And sadly, these certifications, albeit good certifications, don't really impress hiring managers. So if a hiring manager sees them on your resume, in many cases, they're just not going to care. So the certification is not really doing you a lot. But if you don't start with the CompTIA certifications, what could you do instead? Well, here's an idea that you can do. If you don't know, you still want to get those same fundamentals, but you want much deeper and much stronger fundamentals. And you'd also like to do a certification that a hiring manager is going to look at and say, I'd like to talk to this person. They must have worked hard to get this. Maybe they know something. So here's what I would recommend doing. The Net+, you know, is great because it's the fundamentals of network, but it's too junior. So learn networking, but replace the Net+ with a Cisco certified network associate or a Cisco certified network professional. You're going to learn a lot more and potentially could even get a job in networking. Now, the Linux+, again, I would tell you to skip and I would replace it with a Red Hat certified engineer. That will give you strong Linux skills and hiring managers will be impressed. Now let's talk about the A+ certification. This is generally a little bit of PC repair and a few other things. I suggest you not waste your time with this at all. But here's what I want you to do instead. I want you to go out there and build a PC. You know, spec out your PC, pop in the motherboard, pop in the DRAM, pop in the GPU, the CPU, your storage, and really get a feel for that PC. Now take that PC and install a hypervisor on it so you can work with virtualization. And really get hands-on. Download EVENG and do some networking labs directly on this. Create some virtual machines, some Windows virtual machines, some Linux virtual machines. Create, say, a web server with a LAMP stack that's on it to give you a little feel. Maybe set up a VPN server with like OpenSSH, for example. Set up a Microsoft Active Directory server. Create some Windows file shares and some Linux NFS file shares and really get hands-on and learn the skills that employers will care about, the kind of skills that employers will pay for if you're looking for a systems administrator role or an engineering role of some kind. Now, the key is employers hire for skills. So if you go out there and get great skills and get great knowledge, you'll have a great resume and you will get a better job, a far better job that'll pay far more than if you focused on junior level skills. But if you know your goals and you know what you want to do, focus it directly. If you want to know you do networking, start with a CCNA, do a CCNP, and then a CCIE, and poof, you're going to have good, strong networking knowledge. But if you don't know, that generic approach is very good. But life is our most and time is our most precious commodity. We don't have a lot of it. So focus your training time on what matters and go out there and get the results you want to build your career. If you're looking to get your first cloud architect or security architect or AI architect or enterprise architect role, join us for a free webinar. The link is in the description below. We'll talk about these roles and we'll be on Zoom so we can answer any question you may have. We also have a tremendous amount of free resources in this description of this video to help you for your career, and they're all free, so go get them. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video or a webinar.